Hello, EDUSPLORERS. Thanks for joining us again and welcome back to another informative video on our YouTube channel. On today's episode, we are taking you deep inside the beautiful city of Banjul. Banjul is the capital of the country of Gambia in the continent of Africa. We shall explore in details with you with regards to this amazing African city. Why tourists continue to flock into this country, we shall explore its history and more importantly, dive into the Gambia to give you a clear picture with regards to the transformative nature of this amazing African country. We shall close this episode also talking about the history and where the Gambia was and where they are today. So without any more delay, we shall just go straight into it. But before we jump into that in exploring Banjul, allow me give you a clear background with regards to the country of the Gambia. The Gambia is a West African nation bordering the North Atlantic Ocean in the west. The subtropical country is a narrow strip of land on the east side of the Gambian River, just 48 kilometers at its widest point. Within this country, the Gambian River is navigable and also entire land. It is the Gambia's chief transport entry to the country. The smallest country on mainland Africa occupies an area of just over 11,000 kilometers square. It is about the size of the third of Belgium, or slightly less than twice the size of Delaware in the United States. The former British colony forms an enclave within Senegal, with the exceptions of its coast. The country has a population of just over 2 million people, so to point out, based on recent figures. Most of the people live near the coast. Gambia's population is made up of several ethnic groups. About one-third are Madinka, followed by Fula, Wolof and Jolof people. Spoken languages are English official, Malinke and other indigenous language, and also that includes Kleu. More than 95% of the population in the Islamic Republic of the Gambia are Muslims. In considering this, we're going to be taking you straight into Banjul to explore this transformative African city and why this unique African capital has made itself on the map. Banjul is the third largest city and capital of the Gambia, as we've pointed out. It's the smallest nation on the African continent. Some will put that other countries like Seychelles are small, but in the continental Africa, the Gambia is considered to be this particular country. In about 2003, the city had a population of just over 357,000 at a time. People all looking at 19% of the Gambia's total population. If you consider this, the city's name is from a local Mandinka word for a distinctive fiber that was previously harvested on the island for making ropes. Banjul occupies an area of just over 12 kilometers square. If you put that into perspective, and lies at the mouth of the Gambian River on the edge of a small island called Banjul or St. Mary's Island. The city has a subtropical dry and wet climate, with heavy rains from June to October and Harmattan winds that blows during the dry season. If you are new to this channel, we will encourage you to subscribe and share our videos to your different network. Going back to the Banjul and the Gambian history, if you consider the role that Banjul has played in this particular African nation, the history of Banjul began long before the first European arrived. It was settled some centuries, say 10 centuries ago, by African ethnic groups from the interior. The British arrived on April, considering the number or dates, around 1816, founded a town and named it Batox after Henry Batox, the Secretary of the State for British Colony. The British chose this location because they needed a way to better control access to the Gambian River and enforced the Slave Abolition Act of 1807. The act not only prevented British involvement, their warship also stopped American, French, British, Portuguese and Spanish vessels still engaged in slave trade at the time. Over the next 20 years, Batox will become one of the West Africans' hub for British anti-slave naval activities. Considering this, by 1843, Gambia had become a colony with its own governor. In 1889, however, the town was declared the capital of the newly established crown colony and protectorate of the Gambia. When Gambia became independence, that was in 1965, Batox was named the nation's capital. Gambian officially changed the name from Batox to Banjul in 1973. If you are new to our channel, we will encourage you to subscribe and share our videos to your different network. Digging deep a little bit into the history of this amazing African city, the landmarks and festival around Banjul reflects the area's rich culture, act over 22 locations and ends of Independence Drive, commemorates the bloodless coup on July 22 of 1994. A museum within the act displays the country's history and culture. Wildlife is plentiful and also around the city and the River Gambia's National Park has a host of different animals that will attract you. Banjul Demba is the most population, or so the point, most popular of the local festival. Celebrated during the first week of January, the festival puts locals and traditional cultures on display. The May Day Sports Festival is celebrated on May 1st and draws people also coming from different parts across the region and around Banjul, coming even from the diaspora and different parts around the world. Banjul has transformed. Considering this amazing African city, it's become one of the busy hubs within the region, and also it's been known for its architecture in terms of the traditional aspect as well. The nation is moving through a different direction. It has attracted lots of international Africans living in different parts across the world who moved there to experience life or to relocation. The country has done its own area in terms of development in different ways. However, Banjul does face a lot of challenges in different areas. But again, this is common with many African cities within the region. If you are new to our channel, we will encourage you to subscribe and share our videos to your different network. Banjul is a diverse city and has many different ethnic groups, including the Madinka, Fula, Wolof, Jolof, and also Surrey. Although tribal language frequently spoken on the streets of Banjul, English is the official language. Islam is the most popular religion, with more than 90% of the population practicing this faith, so the point out. If you look at Banjul, Banjul does have some international businesses, hotels, companies from different countries from around the world. The country does businesses with different nations within Africa and within the region in West Africa. It also has different international embassies. For you traveling to Banjul, there are lots of places that you would experience. It does have international cuisine, other very interesting aspect as other African cities will offer. If you look at the history of this amazing African city, Banjul has come a long way. Considering that it was one of the countries or one of the cities that played a role, considering when the British were about fighting really hard to end the slavery at the time, as we've pointed out earlier in the video, it's a transformative African city. For those of you who plan to visit Banjul, we'll encourage you to check that out, the information. Of course, there are very good times to visit this amazing African city, but again, while you travel to Banjul, its transformative nature will amaze you. The country just have different beaches, a very experienced places as well. You will explore different museums, African arts in different areas. Again, Banjul, like any major cities across the continent, has its own challenges. These challenges are very common in most African regions. Again, you want to look into that by yourself in planning your journey to explore Banjul. If you are new here, we would encourage you to subscribe and share our videos to your different network. That's all what we got for you with regards to the beautiful city of Banjul in the Gambia. If you've ever been to the Banjul in the past couple of years or months, we would like to hear from you. If you've been there for business or you've traveled there for other activities, we would like to know what your experiences were. Of course, we shall also be looking at hearing from your comments, and let us know what you feel or what your feelings are during your trip. For those of you who have never heard about Banjul, we would advise you to check on to know what this country offers. Its amazing history and very interesting characteristics as one of the cities in Africa and a very hot touristic destination. It has attracted lots of diasporans coming from the United States, from other parts across the world to move to Banjul to live in this beautiful city of the Gambia. For now, I want to thank you for watching our channel. If you are new here, we encourage you to watch our other videos and let us know what inspired you in this video and give up a thumbs up. And the next time, we will be looking forward to meeting you again. For now, thanks for watching the Explorer and have a good day. Bye-bye.